working as an assistant professor in Department of Pharmacology from Dr. D.Y. Patil Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences and Research, Pimpri, Pune, with my colleague Manish Kokani, who is doing his Master in Pharmacy from the same college from Pharmacology Department. Today we are going to learn about the plethysmometer. Plethysmometer, it is a microcontroller volume meter. The main principle behind this plethysmometer is for evaluation or screening of inflammation or edema in a mouse or a rat. It is a specially designed tool for the accurate measurement of mouse or a rat post-swelling. It is a very easy and very reliable instrument for evaluation of anti-inflammatory drugs. Step by step, we are going to see the different parts of this instrument. So you can see, this is a water reservoir, this is a stand, this is a clip which is holding this water reservoir, this is a water cell. Closely you can see there are the two lines. From the bottom, this first line is having a distance of a 3.5 centimeter, the second line is having a 2.5 centimeter. This is a sensor which is useful for the recordings. You can see this is an electronic unit which is having a microprocessor inbuilt into this instrument. All the connections are behind this instrument. You can see there is, this is a screen which is having where we can see the actual reading of the inflammation. There are the different buttons of the functions F1, F2, F3 and F4 and 0. All these functions we can use it for going up, down, or the setting of any date or any calculations, or going back from this screen. This is a electronic unit. You can see below this is a pedal which we can use for the recording of the records of the inflammation or the edema. In this water cell, we have to dip the paw of the rat or the mouse. So from that, we can evaluate the anti-inflammatory activity. As we have discussed the different parts of this plethysmometer, now we are heading towards actual procedure of evaluation of the anti-inflammatory drug by this plethysmometer. For the evaluation purpose, in this reservoir we have used the distilled water with 1% of NaCl solution. 2 to 3 ml of 1% NaCl solution incorporated into the 1 liter of distilled water, which is used into this reservoir for the evaluation purpose. For the evaluation purpose, you're having a different groups. First group, that is a control group. In control group, we are giving saline water solution 0.5 ml by the oral route to the rat. Second group, that is a inducer group. Carrageenan we are using for the inducing of the inflammation or edema by the subcutaneous route into the plantar region of the rat. 1% of the carrageenan drug we are giving by the subcutaneous route in the plantar region of the rat. In the next group, that is for the evaluation of anti-inflammatory drug, we are using indomethacin for the evaluation purpose. 10 mg per kg body weight of the rat we are using for the evaluation of the drug. So let's see how to use this plethysmometer. Now we are taking weight of the animal. For the control group, we are giving 0.5 ml of saline water solution by the oral route. Now we are giving by the oral route saline solution. This is a PAW, which is a control group. There is no any inflammation. We have to dip this into the second tube by this way. Now you can see there is a changing into the electronic meter. So now it is stable. We have to record by this pedal. We are giving 0.1 ml of carrageenan according to the weight of the animal. Now we are inducing the inflammation by using of a carrageenan by giving 0.1 ml by the subplantal root. You can see this is a inflammation because of the carrageenan we have given before 3.5 hours. So now we are going to take the readings of this inflammation. The reading of edema after giving a carrageenan. So now it is stable. We have to record by this pedal. After giving a dose of a carrageenan 1% by the subcutaneous route in the plantal region of a rat, after 3.5 years or a gap of 3.5 hours, we are taking a result of edema or the inflammation. Now we are giving indomethacin, anti-inflammatory drug, 1.79 mg by the oral route dissolved into the saline water. Volume of saline water we have calculated as per the body weight of the animal. Final result of after giving a dose of an anti-inflammatory drug, that is indomethacin. So now it is stable. We have to record by this pedal.
Finally, these are the results. As you all know, for the evaluation purpose, we have used three groups. First group, that is control group. Second group, that is inducer group. And third group, that is test group. For each group, we have taken five readings. And the average of each group, we have calculated. As you can see into the each table, for control group, the average volume, that is 1.15. For inducer group, average volume is 2.26. And for test group, the average volume is 1.52. For the calculation purpose, we have to follow this formula, that is percentage of inhibition is equal to T0 minus TT divided by T0 into 100. This is the major formula for the evaluation of or to calculate the percentage of inhibition of inflammation. In this formula, T0 is nothing but the paw thickness of a rat from inducer group, and TT is nothing but the thickness of a paw of a rat from test group. For the calculation, as you have seen into the results, we have taken the average volume. So the percentage inhibition of inflammation is equal to 2.26 minus 1.52 divided by 2.26 into 100. These values we have taken from the average of each group. So we got the percentage inhibition of inflammation, that is 32.7433%. as per the results, we conclude that the test or standard substance tested shows 32.7433% of inhibition of inflammation. Therefore, the test or standard compound, that means indomethacin, has a significant anti-inflammatory activity. So, this plethysmometer we can use for the evaluation of anti-inflammatory activity as well as to calculate the percentage inhibition of a PAW edema. Thank you very much for watching our video.